Aloha and welcome to Hawaii Vacation News for the week of March 10th, 2008. I'm Colette DeVoe. This news is brought to you by hawaii-aloha.com and Hawaii, Hawaii's experts. The big story for the second week in a row is the lava on the Big Island. Pele, the goddess of volcanoes, has been very busy in the past few days as lava flow reached the ocean, creating a spectacular sight. If it's been your dream to see an active Hawaiian volcano, head over to the Big Island this week. If you go, be sure to bring enough water, wear sturdy shoes, and carry a flashlight at night. Respect this area and be sure to obey all signs regarding safety, as you don't want to anger Madame Pele. We all know a true lady never reveals her age, but in this case, we have to make an exception. The Moana Surfrider Hotel will be celebrating its 107th year. The Moana Hotel, also known as the First Lady of Waikiki, was built in the late 19th century. Construction of the Moana marked the beginning of tourism in Waikiki, becoming the first big hotel amidst the bungalows and beach houses. Opening her doors to guests in 1901, the Moana is still to this day regarded as the flagship of Hawaii tourism and is listed on the National Register of Historic Places. Have you ever wondered where the Mai Tai comes from? Of course not. You have better things to do with your time, such as drinking them. Well, we didn't have anything better to do with our time, so this week we decided to find out. It turns out that the well-known Mai Tai cocktail was purportedly invented at the Trader Vic's Polynesian-themed restaurant in Oakland, California in 1944. However, Don Beach claimed to have created the Mai Tai first in 1933 at his own bar in Hollywood called Don's Beachcomber. Beachcomber. It is unclear who really created the drink, but legend has it that Trader Vic created it one afternoon and tested it on some friends who were visiting from Tahiti. One of them tasted it and cried out, "Mai Tai Roa Ae," which means very good. While there's no Trader Vic's here, my favorite spot for Mai Tai is at the Hula Grill in Waikiki. Well, while we never know who was the true creator of this famous concoction with the Tahitian name, we can all agree that the Mai Tai is one tasty cocktail that will be forever synonymous with Hawaii. Approximately 10,000 humpback whales visit Hawaii each year between the months of November and May, with February being the peak month. This year, we may have record numbers making the journey. The annual migration begins early fall from the Gulf of Alaska. The whales travel nearly 3,500 miles from their feeding grounds in Alaska, taking about 4 to 8 weeks round trip. While the majority of whales end up in the waters off of Maui, they can be seen from many of the Hawaiian islands, including Oahu. It is an amazing once-in-a-lifetime experience to observe the humpback. I recommend you come see these amazing creatures for yourself, and you'll understand why ancient Hawaiians believed the whale to be the god of animals in the ocean. In tourism news, January 2008 marked a 2% increase over last year with honeymooners coming to Hawaii from Japan. Over 10,915 Japanese honeymooners came to Hawaii this past January. In recent years, there have been a decline in Japanese couples tying the knot in Hawaii, leading the Hawaii Tourism Authority just last week to announce plans to attract more visitors from both China and Korea. Nonetheless, the increase in Japanese honeymooners came as a welcome news for Hawaii's Japanese tourism market. In the spotlight today, we're taking you to Maui to visit the Maui Ocean Center. This is a great way to spend the day for adults and children alike.
Today we're taking you inside the Maui Ocean Center. Located at Ma'alea Harbor, it's one of Hawaii's top-rated attractions. Located about 20 minutes from Kihei and 30 minutes from Lahaina, it's centrally located just about an hour or less from most condos and hotels on Maui. Every last being encountered at the Maui Ocean Center is native to the Hawaiian Islands, fostering a more in-depth understanding of marine life than visitors even get during a snorkeling trip or diving excursion. A large variety of fish, coral, marine plants, large sea animals, and more exemplify the underwater environment of one of the rarest aquatic landscapes and biggest Maui tourist attractions in the world. The living reef features amazing, vibrant colors and the marine life that typically feed off them, blanketing the intricate underwater architecture. Green sea turtles are always a big hit with visitors, and many opt for a separate Maui tour that reveal nesting areas and protection programs. You'll find a turtle lagoon, which is a major draw for all ages, and a perfect place to watch the turtles in their natural environment. All in all, there's more than 60 exhibits, including an underwater journey where you can experience a tunnel that offers a 240-degree view of marine life in a 750,000-gallon open ocean tank. This part of the Maui Ocean Center puts you right in the middle of the action where you can get an up-close encounter with marine life.
For more information on the Maui Ocean Center, go to hawaii-aloha.com or call 1-800-843-8771. Taking a look at our island weather for next week, we have a mixed bag in store. It will be mostly dry and the winds will remain on the light side for the next couple of days. And then on Wednesday and Thursday, there will be a 30% chance of scattered showers, and then clearing out to sunny skies over the weekend. Our winds will generally be from the east-southeast at about 10 to 15 miles per hour, but the Big Island will have more easterly winds. Those winds will be light enough to allow for afternoon sea breezes, which will push in some clouds over each of the islands as the days warm up. Those clouds will clear out each night, allowing for cool overnight low temperatures, in some spots dropping down into the 50s. Daytime high temperatures will be in the 80s for most spots. In a word, the weather for next week looks beautiful. Well, that does it for Hawaii Vacation News for this week. Tune in again next Tuesday for more news. In the meantime, for our videos or back episodes, go to our website at hawaii-aloha.com and click on videos. Until next time, my name is Colette, saying aloha and mahalo.